गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर फ्रॉम मोमेंट्स बुक द लॉस्ट चाइल्ड. स्टूडेंट्स, द लॉस्ट चाइल्ड, इट इज अ स्टोरी बाय मुल्कराज आनंद. फर्स्ट वी विल टेक द इंट्रोडक्शन, देन वी विल स्टार्ट रीडिंग द स्टोरी. So students, it is a short story about a child, his aspiration, demands and realization. Though he is attracted by so many things around him, he longs for his parents the most. So this story highlights a child's love for his parents. The child goes to a fair with his parent. He is happy and excited and wants the sweet and toys displayed there. But his parents don't buy them for him. This may be due to two reasons. Either they are not able to afford it, or they feel that a particular thing is not good for the child. But in the end, why then does he refuse when someone else offered them to him? You can get your answer from the story. So let's start reading the story. Students, let's start reading the story. It was the festival of spring. From the wintry shades of narrow lanes and alleys emerged a gaily clad humanity. Some walked, some rode on horses, others sat, being carried in bamboo and bullock carts. One little boy reined between his father's legs, brimming over with life and laughter. So student, it was the festival of spring. After a long winter, spring has come, so people are in a happy mood. They came out from the narrow streets of the village wearing colorful dresses. They used different transport to go to the fair, like some walk, some rode on horses, others used bamboo and bullock carts. One little boy is also there. He reined between his father's leg. He was filled with life and laughter, means he was enjoying the fair. Now the next is, come child, come, called his parents as he lagged behind, fascinated by the toys in the shop that lined the way. He hurried towards his parents, his feet obedient to their call, his eyes still lingering on the receding toys. As he came to where they had stopped to wait for him, he could not suppress the desire of his heart, even though he well knew the old cold stare of refusal in their eyes. I want that toy, he pleaded. His parents called him, come child, come, when he stayed behind, attracted by the toys in the shop that were in the way. He hurriedly went to his parents, but his eyes still hanging around on the toys. His feet obedient to his parents' call, but his eyes still hanging around on the toys. As he reached near his parents, he could not suppress his desire, even though in his heart he knew that his father will refuse his demand. Then also he requested to his father that he wanted that toy. Now the next paragraph. His father looked at him red-eyed in his familiar tyrant's way. His mother, melted by the free spirit of the day, was tender, and giving him her finger to hold, said, look child, what is before you? After requesting the father looked at him in a well-known angry way. His mother was soft in heart, and she distracted the child by saying that, look child, come, hold my finger and come, what is in front of you? It was a flowering mustard field, pale like melting gold as it swept across miles and miles of even land. It was a mustard field full of yellow flowers, and it is looking like that melting gold spread over miles of land. A group of dragonflies were also there, that were bustling about on their gaudy purple wings, intercepting the flight of a long black bee or butterfly in search of sweetness from the flowers. The child followed them in the air with his gaze till one of them would still its wings and rest, and he would try to catch it, but it would go fluttering, flapping up into the air when he had almost caught it in his hand. Then his mother gave a cautionary call, come child, come, come on to the footpath. Means a group of dragonflies with colorful wings and black bee and butterfly were also flying upon the flowers in search of honey. The child followed them in order to catch, but it would go flapping up into the air when he had almost caught it in his hand. During this, her mother again gave him a warning call. Come, child, come, come on the footpath. He ran towards his parents gaily and walked abreast of them for a while, being, however, soon left behind, attracted by the little insect and worms. Along the footpath that were teeming out from their hiding places to enjoy the sunshine, he ran happily towards his parents, but after some time he lagged behind again, attracted by the little insects and worms who came out from the earth on the footpath to enjoy the sunshine.